I've been playing Ghost Recon Wildlands recently. You know, the one that came out early 2017, touting a massive open world and a play your way type of experience. But in my recent playthrough, I can't help but get the feeling, did we miss something the first time? And is there actually a great game hidden in the handholding of AAA games? I have not played any of the Ghost Recon franchise until this game. I have to say as well that I boarded the hype train the moment I saw this beautiful action stealth shooter, with an emphasis on communication, support gadgets like the drone, vehicular combat, and a massive range of weapons and attachments, not to mention the flexibility of all of these things in the field. But what we received was different. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I don't want to focus on the story, because honestly, the story really was not that good. But what surrounds the story is special. I came from a Ubisoft pedigree of Splinter Cell and Rainbow Six, and admittedly, a little bit of The Division, so needless to say, I was excited for a new AAA tactical shooter. Splinter Cell, with its crushing difficulty and clever AI but interesting and innovative stealth mechanics, has set a standard other games find difficult to attain. And Rainbow Six, with the emphasis on team play, communication, strategy, only making it more competitive. Now, the vehicles at launch in Ghost Recon were a disaster, but they created some funny moments.
Like, I saw the grenade coming, but I did not see him just going off the cliff. How did I not?
Christ, wow, you've how already... has this already happened? We've only been playing for like 5
Graham, I don't know if you your combat experience.
Literally, like, oh shit!
Jesus Christ, cunt, do you want me to drive? Oh, oh, that's better.
Oh, Graham's
down. I'm so sorry, Graham.
Jesus Christ, yeah, who's done this to me?
Like, hold down the controller. Holy fuck. No.
Oh, wait, is that not how you do it?
No.
I actually... You're a hero, Graham.
Oh, wow.
Graham from Bundy, this is his specialty.
Since then, they have tweaked it, and it's a lot better. But you'd think for your main mode of transportation, because the map is so big, you'd think they'd work on it a little harder. I thought Ghost Recon Wildlands was going to be the marriage of these two great franchises, with a solid mix of Splinter Cell, stealth, and Rainbow Six teamwork. I thought Ghost Recon was going to be the marriage of these two great franchises, with a solid mix of Splinter Cell, stealth, with Rainbow Six teamwork. But we got something different. Something set on holding our hands, marking targets with big orange circles, and a map bloated with collectibles. It felt far too AAA to be a great action stealth game.
But Chief, at the start of your video, you said that there could be a great game and we might have missed something. But you just spent 5 minutes ripping it to shreds.
Yeah, I did. Because I'm not going to lie to you. Where the greatness comes from in Ghost Recon is when you go into the settings, set the difficulty to maximum, and turn the HUD off. Ah, that's better. By doing this, you essentially tell the AAA part of the game to fuck right off. All of a sudden, you have a massive map, lots of compounds to assault, helicopters to steal, mountains to climb, new gear to find. Becomes a real adventure. And there's no objective markers or anything on the map to hold your hand. Your screen is clear. Even when you mark enemies with the drones, the marks don't stay there. So remembering placement and patrol patterns is a must. This reveals a fantastic stealth action shooter, one that challenges you and encourages you to try different methods of attack. Now that you've made Ghost Recon Wildlands fun, it's time to make it great. Play it with your friends and just watch the carnage ensue.
Oh, you guys just got some cover fire.
That was absolutely ridiculous.
Oh, he was in the house. There was one in the house. I had no idea.
Oh, boy.
Wow. What? Come on.
Dude, I just did two bullets.
Everyone died.
Just fucking field medic.
Mate, you're actually the all-rounder of this group. Achievement unlocked. That was all me.
Oh, relaxing. Just Rhett, a power
please.
Off.
Oh, I just got total pick, so please put that in
the video. Just updating the old loadout, gentlemen. Oh. Hot minute.
Yeah. One hot minute.
Oh, okay, Neil. Straight in.
Is what we failed last time. Infection right. Contact front. Contact front. You've just gone through the front door of an enemy encampment. Everyone out. Target down. They're coming through the front. All right, I am done. I'm from Bundy, Victoria. Oh, Jesus. Stop shooting the goddamn civilians.
No, I just scared him.
Oh,
nice, Graham.
Graham.
Watch it happen. Oh, wow.
I wish that when we were doing Ghost Recon on the channel, we had turned the HUD off. Would have made for some more epic moments. But saying that, we had an absolute blast playing this game. From the serious moments of stealth and tension, to the bounding freedom in rampant destruction. It didn't matter. Ghost Recon Wildlands is definitely a game that works better with friends. Not just because the team AI are fucking useless, but because the game yearns to be played with teamwork, communication, strategy. But the standard game doesn't tell you how to get these things, and have unfortunately lost a lot of their player base because of it. Now, I'm not going to tell you to rush out and pick up this game right now, but I will say this. If you and your friends are looking for a new co-op game to play together, Ghost Recon Wildlands is on sale, then it's actually worth a look. The game can be customized to fit how you like to play. And there is something in there for everyone. All you need to do is drive your hands into the trash to find the treasure. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did enjoy the video, please drop a little like and a subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I'd also like to say thank you to all of our subscribers that we've gotten so far. I'm really happy with the way things are going. Thank you so much for the support, and I'll see you on the next one.